this video, we'll see how you can make use of Android's strong permissions model to secure our application and ensure that your app gets all the resources that is required from the Android system. Android provides a stronger permissions model so that your app is isolated and runs in a sandbox without having any issues from the environment. For example, in earlier videos, we saw that if you want to integrate Facebook, you need internet permission. Without having internet permission, your app cannot access internet and networking libraries provided by Android. And in one of earlier examples as well, you saw how we added a permission called receive SMS. Without adding the permission receive SMS, your app will not allow to sniff the SMS which is received in the Android system. Similarly, there are many other permissions that are provided in Android. Android permissions are generally declared in the manifest file. As you know, the manifest file is a declaration to the Android system what exactly your app has and what are the features provided in your application. Android permissions have various levels. The level can be a system level or the user level or the danger level. So depending on the type of permission you use, your app is categorized. For example, making a phone call is a danger level permission because it may cost money to the user. Sending SMS is a danger level permission because it may cost to the user. GPS location receiving is a danger level permission because it may cause hindrance to the privacy of the user. What if you write an app or someone else may write an app that will send GPS location without knowledge of the user? This may create problem for the user. Hence, Android has defined these as danger level permissions. However, the app can ask user using a prompt that, you know, you want to use the GPS location. If the user accepts and says allow this permission, then only this particular app will be given that permission. The user denies the permission, then the app will not have access to that particular feature. Many permissions are defined as normal permissions. Internet is a normal permission because every app nowadays requires internet. Without having internet, the app may not function properly or the app is of no use at all. WhatsApp requires internet. If internet becomes a danger level permission, then WhatsApp has to keep asking user to allow for the internet permission. Let's understand the permissions model using a sample project. We'll go ahead and create a new app called permissions demo. Create the app, create new activity, empty activity, and launch the. So the project has launched, the main activity is created, and the XML file is generated. So for this exercise, we will not make use of any of these. So as you can see in the Android manifest file, by default, your application has no permissions. In order to use permission, Android provides a tag called users permission. So users permission, these are the names of the permissions in the Android. Android internet, access, course location, find location, stands for GPS location, network state. If I want to access the Wi-Fi state will check if the Wi-Fi is on or not. Account manager, your app, if at all it's using any accounts related API. By accounts, it is under settings, you have Google account added, WhatsApp account added. So these are the accounts manager API. Then another common APIs which I use is Bluetooth, Bluetooth admin API, Bluetooth privileged APIs, sensors. Note that not all the phones may have all the APIs. For example, a tablet which does not have a SIM card slot need not have the telephony APIs, and the permissions, telephony permissions of receive SMS, dial phone may not work in the tablet. So it's very important that once you declare this user's permission, the Android system will go ahead and identify which permission is used by this particular app and allow the application to use that particular service API calls.